Hello friends, in this video lecture we learn the compiler designing practical. The first practical of compiler designing is the implementation of LEX analyzer for the subset of C using the LEX implementation. So next we discuss first about the lexical analyzer. The lexical analyzer is the first phase of a compiler in which we break up the input stream into the usable elements, that's a token. For example, a equal to b plus c into d semicolon. So here a, b, c, d are the identifier, then equal to sign is assignment operator, this is a plus, this is a multiplication and semicolon. So we can do this scanning and recognition by using the lexical analyzer. So for this purpose we use the one tool, that's a LEX. In the Ubuntu, that's a Flex package. So LEX compiler use the LEX language. So how this LEX compiler work? First we write the program in the LEX language, then that program is saved as a .l extension, then we give the command LEX dot name of program dot l to the LEX compiler. It generate the lex.yy.c. This file is given to the C compiler, it generate the a.out. If you want to give the input from the keyboards, we can directly execute this file. If you want to give the input from the one file, that time we use the input file with the a.out and we get a sequence. So let us consider the one program, LEX program, for our understanding ki how the LEX program is written in the LEX language. So this is a first program. This is a first program for LEX. So here this program contains the three section. First section is a definition section, second section is a rule section, and third section is a subroutine. So definition section contain the definitions of terms in the form of regular expression, means if you consider the digit having a 0-9, a regular expression means 0 to 9 number used for the digit. Then if you consider the string is a combinations of alphabet, that's a small or capital letters. Then again in the rule section we invoke this definition for the some action. So definition rule section contain the two parts, calling a definition, and second one is a C section, this is the action. Then YY text is a variable which hold the input stream for comparing with a pattern, this is a pattern. Then main function is there which invoke this yylex function, that yylex function work on this pattern, on the rules, work on these rules. So let us try how this program is run. So I have a one folder CD lab, then second folder CD practical 1, then I save that program by try.l so that I compile directly LEX. Yeah, first you have to use gedit so you get that program. Like gedit is there, this program gedit try dot l, so you get the program directly. Then compile this program LEX try dot l, enter, then automatically one file is generated, that's a lex.yy.c. Again, I repeat this one. I delete this file. I again also delete this one. Then I repeat this command. So automatically this file is generated. Then cc means a.out file is generated by using this command cc lex.yy.c space dash ll means link to the lex library. So we get this one means obviously here a.out file is generated. Then dot execute this a.out file, out, enter. If you enter the 12, then it should be save as digit. Then if you enter the name, that should be a string. It's a combinations of small and capital letter. It also shows if you enter like this, the sum part is digits, second part is a string. Then this is also shown. So this is a complete execution of a program lex. So these three commands are required. First is a lex, name of program dot l, then cc, give to the C compiler, this file is generated, link to the lex library, then for output a dot output is there. So this is a working of lex compiler. So let us start with the program. So we take example as a one input program, simple C program is there. We use this program for detection every token. So I already have a one program, program dot l. Same three sections are there. This is a definition section, third one is a rule section, and this one is a subroutine. So first understand about the definition section. So you already know about this one. Then header file, about the header file, how this definition is written. So again I go to the input text. So in the header file, this part is always fixed, there is no change. So in the program I return that part in the double quote, means there is no requirement of a regular expression. Then this part is not fixed, this part is not fixed here, stdio.h, here coin.h, means it's a combinations of alphabets. So that here we can use the regular expression. Then dot h close bracket, again this is also fixed part, so in the double quote. Yeah. In general those are fixed, that should be written in the double quote. Those having a regular expression, that should be put directly, so that in the printf statement, then scanf statement is there. Then here slash t means if any tab is recognized or blank space is recognized, so that should be a give a count as a token, count as a token. But there is no need to say that ki here is a tab, there is a tab, there is no not to recognize, we want to words only. Then similarly for the comment, it shows like this, this is a fixed part. Then any combinations of words mean dot star. Dot star recognized for what? It's a any combinations of word, digit, special character like this. Then main function directly we have given, there is no requirement of any regular expression. So like this, all for the all parts we return a some patterns definitions, and just we call that one. Here we want to take care of this one key, operator spelling should be same here also, because it should be work as a variable. This is as a work as a variable, the word. The word value in the word's value in the pattern of this one. So always word should be same. Spelling should be same. So this is a definition and rule section. Then we want to give the input from the file, so that here we make a one subroutine for the file handling. Just file pointer is there. That file pointer open the file in the read mode. Then again YY in one by one file word considered to the YY in, then it should be passed to the YY lex as a YY to the YY text, and YY text compare with this pattern and give the output. So this is a working of this program. So let us try to execute. So clear screen, Control C, clear, then lex. I have saved the name with the program 1.l, then cc lex dot yy dot c space dash ll, then dot forward slash a dot out, and give the input file name input dot txt. So here we get output. Here we get the output for every token. For the every token key header file. This is a header file. This is a coino.h, again header file, void main main function. If you compare with input file, then we get the definition for every tokens. Definition for every tokens. So just compare with this one. Key include, then void main, then clear screen, then this is a data types, then this is variable, then semicolon, then printf statement, then terminator is there, then scanf statement, means every token is recognized by this program. So try this program. It's a very simple program. In this program we use the sum character, and maybe in the next program we require this one. So just take a review key which tokens are used for the lex programs. So these are the special character for the lex. These are the special character for the lex. Dot means any character expected as a new line except the new line, then literals, then new lines, then tabs, then beginning of a line, then dollar, then this one is operator. This one are the operator, question marks, zero or one copy, then any combination, then plus means what, at least one, then or. So it's like a regular expression. This operator like a regular expression we may use in the definition section as well as rule section also. Then these are the character class, means a b c d. We have used a dash a dash z, any letter through the z. So like this one, these are the character class. Then some more function are required in the lex. That's one are why we in function we just use this one input stream pointer. From the fp file pointer you take the value and pass to the next yylex. Then yylex is the entry point for the lex, means it's follow the rules. Then yytext is a buffer holder, means it's hold the value and match with a pattern. Then length of lex, mean that's a yy LNG. Then token value, this variable used for the token value, this variable used for the local value. So these variables we have used in next program. That time I again recall this one. So let us try this program. It's a very simple. If you perfect in the first program, obviously you can ready for the next program as well. So thank you for watching this one. Thank you so much.